I prayed and I fasted this week for spiritual guidance. I prayed and I fasted this week to examine myself. You got to think right now and consider, why do you fast and pray? Or why didn't you fast and pray? I'm humbled and I'm grateful for the opportunity for this sinner to stand here and break the bread of life of God's people at Grand Concourse for the next 7 consecutive days. It's a heavy responsibility. I want you to understand that I do not deserve to stand here. But by the grace of God, I have a very important request to make of you as we begin this 7-day journey. Actually, it's not a request. I am begging you. Please pray for me. I can't do this by myself. Pray for the preacher. My adopted relative in St. Kitts, those of you who know I had traveled to St. Kitts last year, right sitting right there, got the call, he died this morning. I tell you about that plague that they call cancer. What about memories of when I got the call? I remember the Thanksgiving service 4 years ago, sitting, get ready to preach, got the call saying my mom died, I had to get up and speak. I know they mean when I say pray for the preacher. You. When you're doing something for God, that's when the devil attacks you. If he's not attacking you, you're not doing anything at all. And he's fine, he has you. Are you listening to what I'm saying here? If the devil is not attacking you, then you're on his side. He has you already. But the moment you open up your mouth for Jesus, he can get to you, he gets to your family. He goes to your husband, he goes to your sister, he goes to your son, your daughter, you. Also, remember Sister Alpha's sister, we praise you, remember Sister Carol Lopez, to send ourselves this tomorrow. We'll get the link to you. So let's support a virtually, okay? We'll get the link to you, and we'll be online tomorrow from virtually to support our sister as we lay the foot to the rest, okay? A revival means that. The messages are for us. The messages are for me, not for somebody out there. For a revival is not the time when you say, "Peace, tell them, Pastor." That's not a revival. That revival is complete. For followers of Christ, for the members of this church, it's for folks who claim that they love you. It's for us, for me. And if you have one sermon they see you're supposed to miss, it should have been this one. But you can't miss the other seven. So think you're here already. Because you can't miss tomorrow night, nor any of the other five nights to follow. 7:29 every night. 7:30 to 7:29. 7:29 every night, we're here Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday, and then we're online on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday. I want you to make sure, as we get down to God's business, that you have your Bible printed or electronic, or your app, whatever you have, because things may be said, and you may say, "Really, I want you to be in the Word." Because what I say can be challenged, but this can't be challenged. So I don't want you to read from here and say, "The teacher said." I want you to read from here and say, "The teacher read." So make sure you're in the Word. Thank you so much, Mr. Dominic, for reading for us. You don't need to read it again. But I want to make sure that you're in the book of Acts. Make sure in the book of Acts and place God's magnifying glass on chapter 2. And put his microscope of the Holy Spirit on verses 1 through to 14, that whole territory. I want to tag this message, "Standing in Power." Standing in power. Every head in here is bowed and every eye in here is closed. Our Father and our God, you have called me and I have answered. Father, I need your help. Before we do here, so I need your help, Daddy. I am nothing. You are everything. To do what you do best, and please use the feeble list of prayers to speak words of life to the children. I pray that you speak to me so that your people will only hear your voice. Daddy, may this lump of clay not deceive me, but let Jesus alone deliver us. We are ready to receive your word. We have our cups raised. Fill them up, Lord. Speak to us now, Father. Your children at Grand Concourse are listening. Because we are in the strong, mighty, matchless, powerful, but sweet name of Jesus that all of our children put together. Amen, and amen again. Standing in power. Standing in power. Since the messages are for us, and sometimes the messages are the messages out sometimes to people, I want to put a stake before we begin that throughout these 7 days, the forces of the sermon that you can say, and then you hope you could say out. So you can say out. And if there's anything to do, you can use the message. I want to take it out because God is going to do it. That is the problem. You know, all of the religious today, we come to the day of Pentecost.
Thank you. I'm going to do this. Thank you. I want to I'm going to take this off the
The Bible says, God the Lord has said, the Son of God, the Son of God, the Son of God,
you have
I have a double. You are not I'm
speak the word of God. I don't know what I know God. I don't know God. I don't know God. I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the next one.